Welcome to the session. Today I am going to take the session on calculus and analytical geometry from unit 3. My topic is two-path test for non-existence of limit. As we know, if at all limit exists, that must be unique. So using this observation or definition, we have this path. You have this test, two-path test. Says that if you have two different paths at which the limit is different, if at all you get the two different paths along which the limits are different, we can conclude that the limit does not exist. This is two path test. As in the case of we know in the case of single variable function, this is say point x is equal to a. If left hand, we can approach this point, particular point, from the left or right side. If at all left hand limit and right hand limits are different, we can conclude that that limit does not exist. Here also, in the two dimensional function in two variables, here this is the point say x naught y naught. We can approach this given point from different, there are infinitely many paths to approach the given point. So if at all limit exists, all these limits should be equal, single limit. So if at all you get, suppose this is the point x naught y naught, suppose we get two different paths, say one is this one, say another one is here, these two limits are different, then we can conclude that that limit of that function as x y tends to x naught y naught does not exist. This is two path test. This is used to prove the particular limit does not exist. Let's take one example. Consider this function f of x y is equal to 2x square y divided by x power 4 plus y square. Let's check the limit of this function as xy tends to the origin at this particular point. So we shall check. Actually, we are going to prove a limit of f of xy as xy tends to the origin does not exist using two path test. So we try to find two different paths at which the limits are different. So for this, consider the line curve. Consider the curve y is equal to mx square, say x not equal to 0. So we will find the function values along these curves. F of xy evaluated at this curve, y is equal to mx square, x not equal to 0. Function is 2x square y divided by x power 4 plus y square evaluated at y is equal to mx square. So y is equal to mx square. So it is 2x square into mx square divided by x power 4 plus y square. Y is mx square. So it is mx square whole square. So it is nothing but x. This is 2m x power 4. Here x power 4 plus m square x power 4. So it is 2x power 4 m square divided by, we can take out x power 4 outside, so it is 1 plus m square. Can cancel this x power 4, x not equal to 0, we can cancel the non-zero term. So function value along the line, along the curve y is equal to mx square is 2m square divided by 1 plus m square. So this is the function value along the curve y is equal to mx square. So if we take the limit that depends on m, for instance, take say m is equal to 1, that is the line y is equal to mx. So m is equal to 1, so y is equal to mx square, x square, y is equal to x square. So along this curve, what about the limit? Limit of that function f of x, y along the line y is equal to x square, put m is equal to 1 here, we get limit as 2 into 1 square, that is 2, 1 plus 1, 2, 2 by 2, 1. So limit of this function along the curve y is equal to x square, this, if you approach the origin along this curve, limit is 1. So take another path, say take m is equal to 0, y is equal to mx square, take m is equal to 0, then y is equal to 0, that is the x axis, approach the origin through x axis, what we get, what is the limit? So limit of this function f of x, y along the x axis, if we approach the origin along this x axis, value of function is m is equal to 0, 2 into 0 divided by 1, 0 by 1, that is 0. So limit is 0. So we get these two different paths to approach origin. One is this y is equal to x square curve. Along this curve, if you approach the origin, limit of the function is 1. If you approach the origin along this x axis, limit is 0. So we get two different paths where the limits are different. So by this two path test, we obtained these two paths with two different limits. So by this test, we can conclude that this limit does not exist. So limit of f of xy as xy tends to the origin does not exist. So this is how we use two path test to prove the limit does not exist. I hope you like the video. Thanks for watching.